private equity meets public protest. The housing market is not working for these Londoners. Even the dogs on the street know it.
Housing is a human right, not a privilege.
What business have an American development firm got?
Along with some celebrity friends, they were outside the offices of American private equity firm Westbrook Partners. They bought the low-rent housing estate in East London where these people live. The fear that they'll refurbish, rejig tenancies and relet on a higher rent. There's a global paradox in this local tale, though.
Westbrook are all about purely making money. Ironically, their main shareholders are pension funds in America for public service workers. So it's clearly a paradoxical situation that we're in.
Westbrook, for their part, say they're responsible landlords and the tenancy agreements won't change until next year. Then it was on to Downing Street and a 300,000-strong petition into number 10.
And it's not just Hackney, it's across London, it's across the country. Why are they not building more social housing for people? Why are people being pushed and forced out of London?
I mean, part of the problem is the super rich buying property in London, isn't it? How much did you pay for your place?
It's rented. What
kind of rent are you paying?
Oh, I'm not interested in talking to you about my rent, mate. I'm here to support a very, very important campaign. And you, as a member of the media, have an important duty to help to represent these people.
But it's still a point, isn't it?
I mean, the demand that the super rich are putting on the London property market.
Unless you're proposing.
No, absolutely not. I would completely deny that. I'd say I'm part of the solution. People coming together to amplify the voices of ordinary people. That's precisely what's needed. There's no greater, more expensive piece of real estate in London than that one, and the people in there are the people that have the obligation.
I'd say your house is nearly on par,
it's rented. We don't know the value. You'd have to talk to my landlord. Blessedly, I can afford my rent and I'm prepared to stand up for people that
Liz
can't.
Russell's
it's been lovely talking to you.
People. David Cameron isn't. Lise Russell-Brown's actually standing up regardless of how big his house is and coming down and helping ordinary
and maybe
people.
After the demo in the estate's local, and the Bradleys are talking private equity and the housing market.
None of your kids can afford to live where you live.
Three generations of this family lived on this estate.
Until now, basically, this is the end of it.
We've already started to split up because of what they're going to do to us.
This story is both local and global at the same time. It speaks to a tension around what happens when people's homes also become a windfall for global investment companies.
There isn't yet a huge tradition or a huge component of large international companies owning residential property in central London, but it is coming. And it's not necessarily a bad thing because they're often very good landlords, they have very high standards.
The estates that these new institutions end up buying will only end up as good or as bad as their new owners. The point is, the Bradleys don't know or trust the new owners of the new era estate.
10 years from now, Jan, worst possible case scenario, what will it be like?
Dead. It'd just be dead. There'd be nothing here.
It'd be gone.
It'd be gone.